गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम बैक इन अवर वीडियो लेक्चर विद द सेम टॉपिक दैट इज क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन एंड मैनेजमेंट. सो इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट अ फर्स्ट एग्रीकल्चरल प्रैक्टिस दैट इज प्रिपरेशन ऑफ सॉइल. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर थर्ड एग्रीकल्चरल प्रैक्टिस दैट इज सोइंग. सो वॉट इज सोइंग? सोइंग इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन एंड इन सिंपल वर्ड्स वी कैन से सोइंग इज जस्ट प्लेसिंग द सीड इन सॉइल फॉर ग्रोइंग क्रॉप प्लांट्स. वॉट इज सोइंग? इट इज जस्ट प्लेसिंग द सीड इन सॉइल फॉर ग्रोइंग क्रॉप प्लांट एंड सोइंग इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ प्लांटिंग. सो यू कैन जस्ट राइट डाउन इन सिंपल वर्ड्स. वॉट इज सोइंग? सोइंग इज प्लेसिंग द सीड इन सॉइल फॉर ग्रोइंग क्रॉप प्लांट्स. सोइंग इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ प्लांटिंग. सो बिफोर सोइंग वी हैव टू डू समथिंग. मीन्स some conditions are there for sowing, that selection of seeds, this is very important before sowing. So selection of seeds include, that seed should be healthy, it is of high yielding, it is of good quality, and that seeds should be free from insects and diseases. So these criterias are important for selection of seeds. Which criteria? That seeds should be healthy, of high yielding, of good quality, and that seeds should be free from insects and diseases. So how can we identify whether the given seeds are healthy or damaged? So one simple activity is there which is given in your textbook. So related to that activity, I am going to explain this point. We can separate good healthy seeds from damaged seeds by putting them in water. This is simple method to identify whether the seed is damaged or healthy. So when you just put that seeds into water, then what will happen? Damaged seeds are just hollow. Because of their means that seeds becomes hollow and these seeds are lighter in weight. So when you just put that seeds in water, then what will happen? As the damaged seeds are hollow and lighter, they just float on water. And the seeds which are settled down at the bottom, these are healthy seeds. Okay. So you can separate these healthy seeds from damaged seeds by using this simple method. One activity is given in your textbook related to this. You just read that activity, you will understand. Okay. So this sowing is done by some methods. So before sowing, one of the important tasks is to know about the tools used for sowing seeds. So traditional tools are there also, then broadcasting is there, and seed drill. These three methods are used for sowing. So what is traditional tool? So you can see in the diagram, the tool used traditionally for sowing seeds is just like a funnel. You can see at the top there is funnel and the seeds are filled into the funnel, and then these seeds pass down through the two or three pipes are provided to the funnel, and these pipes have sharp ends. So these seeds are just come down through that pipe, and then because of these sharp ends, these ends are just pierced into the soil and these seeds are just placed there. Okay, this type is of method is traditional method. So traditional use, traditional tool which is used for sowing is, you can see in the diagram, these seeds are just filled into the funnel, then seeds pass down through two or three pipes having sharp ends. These sharp ends pierce into the soil and place the seeds there. Then one more method is there, which is not given in your textbook, but this method is commonly used. It is called broadcasting or seed scattering. So you can see in the picture, the people are just scattered that seeds randomly here and there. Then what will happen? That seed just randomly spread. They just fall down on the ground, and when they get favorable condition, that seed just germinate. Okay. Then third method is seed drill. This is modern method of sowing. Nowadays, this seed drill is used for sowing with the help of tractors. So what is the benefit of this seed drill? By using this seed drill, these seeds are just uniformly sowed at proper distance and proper depth, preventing overcrowding. So what happens during overcrowding? If you just sow that seeds near to each other, then what will happen? That seeds cannot germinate properly. That seedling or plant cannot get sufficient sunlight or sufficient nutrients from soil. So that's why there should be proper distance between two seeds, and that distance is maintained by this seed drill method. So it ensures that seeds get covered by the soil after sowing. One more benefit of this seed drill is, as soon as the seed is just sown into that ground, seed get covered with soil by that machine, and this protects the seeds from being eaten by birds, and that's why this is one more benefit. And this sowing by seed drill saves time and labor. So this is the seed drill. So what is seed drill? So a seed drill sows the seeds uniformly at proper distances and depths, and it prevents from overcrowding, because in seed drills the proper distance between two seeds is maintained. It ensures that seeds get covered by the soil after sowing, and it prevents damage caused by birds. And last point is, it saves time and labor. So these seeds, all these methods that just now we have studied are of direct sowing. Then one more method is there, which is called transplanting. So you can see in the picture, and by that by watching that picture, you can easily get idea about transplanting. So this transplanting, we done this transplanting for paddy. Nowadays this transplanting is done everywhere. Means it is many people in our surrounding, they are just doing this transplanting. So what is transplanting? In transplanting, first that seeds are just grow in nursery, and then when these seeds are just grow into seedling, then that seedling just transplanted to the field manually. So some forest plants and flowering plants are also grown in nursery. So what is transplanting? In transplanting, seeds of few plants such as paddy are first grown in nursery. When they grow into seedling, they are just transplanted to the field manually. And some forest plants and flowering plants are also grown in the nursery. So this is transplanting. Then next point is, means we have completed this sowing. So what we have studied in sowing? What is sowing? Then what are the criteria for selection of seedling? Which method we use to identify whether the seeds are damaged or healthy? Then what are the tools which are used for sowing? In that, three methods are direct methods and one is transplanting. So seed scattering, then traditional tools and modern tools by seed drill. These are direct methods, and transplanting is one more method. So next point in agricultural practices is adding manure and fertilizer. So both these words, we have heard about this manure and fertilizer. So what is manure? Manure is natural fertilizer. And what is fertilizer? Fertilizer is chemical substance. So manure is organic matter obtained from the decomposition of dead plants and animal waste by the action of microorganisms. This manure supplies nutrients and organic material to the soil, and it just increases fertility of that soil. So manures are natural fertilizers, and manures are of four types: farmyard manure, compost, vermicompost, and green manure. So what is farmyard manure? This includes all this waste from farm, that is cattle dung and urine, then leftover of age of fodder of cattle sheds. These are the farmyard manure. Then when we are talking about compost is the manure prepared by degrading the waste material like livestock excreta, then vegetable waste, sewage waste, then eradicated waste, weeds. This is compost. Then what is vermicompost? Vermicompost is the manure prepared by using earthworms to speed up the process of decomposition of plants and animal waste. Then last one is green manure. It involves growing of plants such as the sunny hemp, then cowpea and cluster beans, then mulching by plugging these plants into the soil. So these are the types of manure.
So what are the advantages of manure? Manure enrich the soil with nutrients. As there is no chemical, this is very useful for a soil. It just increases the fertility of soil. Then manures add organic matter called humus to the soil, and the humus improves the texture of soil and improves the retention of water in sandy soil. It just enables drainage and aeration in clay soil. Manure helps recycle farm waste. Means because of this manure, we can recycle all farm waste. Then environmental pollution caused by use of chemical fertilizer, it gets reduced by using manures. But along with these advantages, manure also has some disadvantages. As these manures are bulky, so it is very inconvenient to handle, store and transport them. And these are not nutrient specific. Means if you have studied about these plants, require particular plants require particular nutrients in a definite proportion, so in adequate amount. And manure consists of all nutrients. So when we are talking about a certain or we just want particular nutrient for particular plant, then that condition is not possible in manure. And this release of nutrients by manure is very slow, as these are natural fertilizers. Their process is very slow. Then what is fertilizer? Fertilizers are synthetic chemical substances, and that are added to the soil to overcome nutrient deficiency. And these also enhance the fertility of soil. And these fertilizers contains higher amount of nutrients as compared to manures. So which elements or which compounds are present in fertilizers? Fertilizers supply NPK to the soil. Then what is NPK? It's nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. Fertilizers are prepared in concentrated form, so it is easy to transport them. These are available in the form of granules, water soluble powder or solution, so it is very easy to use these fertilizers. And these fertilizers are just means these are high cost cost farming accounts for higher yields. Means when farmer is doing that agricultural practices in higher or on large scale, then fertilizers are beneficial to that farmers. Then fertilizers are of different types, like nitrogenous fertilizer, phosphatic fertilizers, potassic fertilizers, complex or mixed fertilizers. So these are the fertilizers. Then when we are talking about difference between manure and fertilizer, it is also given in your textbook, and one activity is given in your textbook. So you have to just plant growing seedling with manure and fertilizer and without manure and fertilizer. So you can see in the diagram what is the difference between these two seedlings or two plants. The plant in which we are just adding that manure and fertilizer, it grows healthy. And plant without adding manure and fertilizer, you can see in the diagram how it looks. So when we just add manure and fertilizers, then plant just get all that nutrients which are essential for its growth. Then what is difference between this fertilizer and manure? Fertilizer is man-made, synthetic, chemical. Manure is natural substance obtained by decomposition of cattle dung and plant residue. Fertilizers prepared in factories and manures can be prepared in the field. Fertilizers does not provide any humus to the soil. Manures provide a lot of humus to the soil. Fertilizers are very rich in plant nutrients. Which nutrients? Just now I told you, NPK, nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. And manure is relatively less rich in plant nutrients. Okay, then one more. Soil pH remains unchanged when we just add that manure to it. But because of this fertilizer, soil pH may get changed. It becomes acidic or basic. Then this manure is bulky and difficult to store and transport. Fertilizers are very easy to store and transport. Then manure is biodegradable and fertilizers are non-biodegradable by nature. So these are the points, or these are the different points between difference between fertilizer and manure. So I hope you got all points related to fertilizers and manure. Then along with this adding fertilizer and manure, some more methods are there. By using that methods, we can just increase fertility of soil. We can just replenish that nutrients from the soil. So which two methods are there? One is crop rotation, and mixed cropping is there also. then crop, fatal crop, this method is there. So you can see in the diagram what is crop rotation. Crop rotation, we can see in the simple word that crop rotation is done by growing different crops alternately. Means when we are just cultivating same crop in the field for more than 2 years, then what will happen? Nutrients required for that plants just consumed by that plant from that soil, and the quantity, the amount of that nutrient get reduced into that soil. So it takes a long time to form that nutrients again in the soil. So we can just do this by using this crop rotation, growing different crops alternatively. Means legumes, legume grains can be alternated by cereals. This is one method for increasing that fertility of soil. We can just increase fertility of soil by crop rotation. Then this crop rotation is done by 1 year rotation, 2 year rotation, or 3 year rotation. As different crops absorb different nutrients from the different layers of soil, nutrients of the soil are utilized and do not deplete fast. Means use of leguminous pulses crop helps in the enrichment of soil. And when varied crops are grown by rotation, the growth of the pests and weeds slows down because they do not find favorable condition to multiply. This is one more benefit of that crop rotation. So this is crop rotation. And last point is crop fallow crop. So what is crop fallow crop? Crop fallow crop is just leaving the field uncultivated between two crops. It also helps to restore these nutrients in soil. And fallow land means a land that is normally used for growing crops, but it is left uncultivated for a season in order to let it recover its fertility. So by using this crop rotation, crop fallow crop method, we can replenish the nutrients from the soil. So I hope you got all points related to sowing and fertilizers and manure. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you.